Welcome back to History with Mr. P. July 3rd, 1863, the Battle of Gettysburg reaches its climactic moment with the infamous event known as Pickett's Charge. Here's the deets. Battle of Gettysburg, which took place from July 1st to July 3rd, 1863, was a pivotal engagement during the American Civil War. On the third day of the battle, General Robert E. Lee of the Confederate Army sought to break the Union lines and win a decisive victory. To accomplish this, Lee devised a daring assault known as Pickett's Charge. Pickett's Charge was a plan that involved massive infantry assault across open ground toward the center of the Union line onto Cemetery Ridge. General George Pickett, along with General James Longstreet and A.P. Hill, would lead the Confederate attack. Around 1 p.m. on July 3rd, Confederate artillery began bombarding the Union positions to soften their defenses. For about 2 hours, cannons on both sides engaged in a fierce and thunderous exchange. The Confederate bombardment was intended to weaken the Union lines and create a gap for the infantry assault. Around 3 p.m., as the cannon fire subsided, approximately 12,500 Confederate soldiers advanced across a nearly mile of open ground. They faced intense enemy fire as Union artillery and infantry unleashed devastating volleys into their ranks. Pickett's men bravely marched forward, enduring heavy losses, but still pushing onward. As the Confederates neared the Union lines, they faced a barrage of musket fire and canister shot, which mowed down many soldiers. Union troops under the command of General Winfield Scott Hancock and other Union generals repulsed the Confederate advance with a devastating crossfire. Despite their determination, the Confederates could not break the Union line. Pickett's Charge resulted in heavy casualties for the Confederate Army, with the estimates of around 6,000 to 7,000 soldiers killed, wounded, or captured. It marked a significant turning point in the battle, as the failed assault dealt a severe blow to the Confederate morale and hopes of victory. The Battle of Gettysburg ultimately ended in a Union victory. The Confederate Army retreated from the field on July 4, 1863, and Union forces held their ground. The battle was a major setback for General Lee and the Confederates, hindering and their ambitions to invade the North and potentially influence the outcome of the war. Thanks for stopping in today with History with Mr. B and the Battle of Gettysburg, and I'll see you folks tomorrow.